live from home base, where all the candy is. It's the Mastication Station. With your host, because he's the sane one, Tony J. Lemon. And old enough to be his sister, the studio ed, Lee Daly. Tonight's special guest, TV personality and professional celebrity introducer, Dirk Rowley. Our musical guest from the Upper Midwest, Buttigieg. Our sponsor tonight is the Jethro Tull Metalworks Company. It'll shoo you away. And now, rumor has it he ain't got your love anymore. Tony J. Lemon.
Whoa. Wait a minute. Oh, hey, that was fun. That was one of those things that in Thailand, I think they call it a tap-tap or something. That was my, there she goes.
Understudy.
Yeah, hey, welcome. To, there you are. Hey, welcome to Mastication Station. Don't hang up. There was a guy in the audience that said that earlier. I thought that was a really strange pickup line. It is spring. Spring has sprung, everybody. Aren't you excited? I'm so glad the snow is gone now, so now I can see where I left the goose poop, placed it there last fall for so I could know how to get home. So I found it again. Yeah, so welcome, please. Stunt double for the studio ed. The studio.
Thank you. Good to be back. Good to be here, Tony. We are in Fort Wayne.
Yes.
We've been all over the country, and we came back to our home base. We're preparing for our next trip when our bus driver, Bob Jones, told us the bus would not be ready for a week. So that's why we're here at our home studio.
Yes.
And we are, the audience members tonight are all from the 101 Odd Fellows Club. And we'd like to thank you gentlemen for being odd and fellows.
And the plants, though. I was surprised how much has grown since we've been gone.
Right. Well, remember when we were on the East Coast? It was National Invasive Plant Month.
Yes, yes.
Well, they shipped us some of their invasive plants.
Oh, how nice.
And that's why we have them here at our studio. Just don't touch them.
That was Roundup, wasn't it? Or Round Down?
Roundabout. Yeah. They said specifically for us not to come in human contact with the plants.
Whoops. Well, so I'll wash my
hope
hands.
You didn't brush any when you came in.
Well, I kind of
ate understudy
some.
Pushed you in.
I did lick a few plants, but other than that, I should be fine.
Good, I can take over the show.
Yay! Well, that's all I have. Do we have how many in the audience?
We have, my numbers are accurate, 837.
837
Odd Fellows. Even, well, 836. 835.
Okay. Did those guys touch points?
I don't know.
Yeah. So,
well, they're odd, so,
whoever's left after the show, we'll go to the Hotel One and have a roundabout with the
pineapple
thing. Drink. What's that called?
Singapore Sling.
Oh.
Oh, no, it's the Pangalactic Gargle Blaster. From our friends on the Hitchhikers of the Guide of the Galaxy.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Here, only I thought you one is all we can
all
have, too, and you're done.
Yeah, bye-bye.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we have also come back to Fort Wayne for a very specific reason. There was a very special guest that we wanted to get, and he booked with us, and we were very excited about it.
Wildly excited.
And he canceled, so.
You stay in the room. I'll make sure he doesn't leave.
That's not going to happen. So with us tonight is another special guest, and he is from the TV station here in Fort Wayne, Wayne 15, and his name is Dirk Rowley, and he is a media mogul. He has been in all kinds of platforms, radio, TV, microfish, anything you can think of, he's done it.
Microwave.
And so, what?
Microwave.
He's There's my microwave right there.
Local boy.
Little microwave. So he's here tonight, so we're really excited about that. So we'll be back after this, and we'll see you later. And if we don't, we won't see you later. See ya.
Bye-bye.
Mastication Station, North America's oddest local talk show. Almost every Thursday night at 9 on Facebook Live. Guests, games, fun, and gluten-free. So put the kids to bed, grab a snifter of hot dog water, and join the festivities. Click like, share, revel in the fun, repeat. Almost every Thursday night at 9 on Facebook Live.
That's not a bad idea. That's not a bad idea. Hey, hey, are we back? Are we back? Yes.
Yeah, we're back.
We're back. Welcome back to Mastication Station. And Lee is going to tell you who the sponsor is because I never remember who it is.
Yeah, ever. You don't read the emails.
Well, I
so our sponsor this week is the Jethro Tull Cowbell and Ironworks Company here in Fort Wayne.
Woo!
You know, we tend to bring in the weirdest sponsors. Uh-huh. But, you know, he paid for all of these metal works you see around the studio. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and
there's no metal work.
That was almost as good as when we had the gluten sponsor the
You're
show
not
for a while.
Supposed to mention that, Tony, because we got lawsuits for that, remember? Plants.
Yeah, and how many in the audience?
835 Five. From the Odd Fellows, 101 Odd Fellows. So yes. Thank you, gentlemen.
Everyone.
Thank you, gentlemen, for being here and being odd.
And fellows.
So there's no girls in the whole audience, you know?
That's a design flaw for sure. Hey, with us is a special guest. His name is Dirk Rowley, and he's here from the news. Say hi, everybody.
Oh, here we go. Yeah. Actually, no, it's just like being on at Wayne 15.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, and to make you feel a little more comfortable.
A little more uncomfortable?
A little comfortable. I thought I'd bring a pizza box with the emblem here. Now he's official.
That's so nice.
Yeah. Remember when we had the
Your
portable
audience?
Yeah.
The audience
my
left.
Instrument here that I've invented. It's called the portable heckle-free audience. Hi, ladies and gentlemen. Good to see you.
Good.
Kind of lost sound.
Good look.
But whatever.
I'm glad I wore black because there's nothing in the background that's black here, so that was a good choice.
Blend right into the chair.
So we are really privileged to have you here. I think that it would be really cool to hear about what goes into making a news half-hour block or whatever.
More than people think. You know, the producers get in for the 5 o'clock show at 8 o'clock, the 6 o'clock show about the same time. So, okay. I mean, it's a full day. And then at the last minute, something can happen, and it all changes, and suddenly you're, you know, wherever, reporting live from a, you know.
From some weird location.
Some weird location.
Yeah.
Fire.
Yeah. So you've got to get the stories. Do you write a lot of the material yourself? Do you have people writing it kind of helping you
the
write
anchor
it?
Job's more of an editor's job. So, you know, Tara and I come in around 2:30, and then start to read the scripts, you know, are they clear, understandable to somebody who doesn't know this story that we walk into? What can we do to improve it? What questions do we have? Are we leaving out key facts? Can we add context, you know, to things that have happened? You know, oh, by the way, there's this history with that company, those kind of things.
Mm.
So it's kind of like an editor's job, but occasionally you get to report stories on our own. I mean, Tara does Positively Fort Wayne every week that airs Monday.
Okay.
That's kind of that positive spin on the news.
Mm-hmm.
That's good.
And, you know, clever name, Positively Fort Wayne. and then I kind of just get to pick and choose stories that I find interesting, people I find interesting, get to report on that. And
Do you have to fact check?
Do I have to fact check?
I mean, we don't.
Do you get to?
Yeah, I mean, you know, they,
we find
they,
our
they
stories
like
are
it.
More interesting if we don't.
Yeah. It would be much more interesting if we didn't.
See,
yeah.
Tony, that's our calling card right there.
To what? Fact check?
Not fact check.
Oh, not fact check.
You are fake news,
sir.
So everything you're saying is not true at all.
Yeah.
Well, can't be proven in court of law.
Right. Yeah. And no. And the beautiful thing is, thanks to Facebook and social media, if you don't fact check, you find out pretty quick. People love to point out spelling errors.
Okay.
There was a time when the web page, the spell check on the web page for about a week just went, out.
Yikes.
That's why we teach spelling, Tony.
Yeah.
That's a good tip. Yeah.
So do you have a lot of people following you on social media?
That.
Like, your show, telling. You just
no,
to kind
of... No, I mean, Wayne 15, you know, people follow the station. Mm-hmm. You know, it's a huge Facebook presence. Mm-hmm. So not the individuals of us. You
okay.
know. I friend people on Facebook, though. If you live in Fort Wayne and you send me a friend request, yeah. I typically say yes.
Uh-huh. Oh. Until you hear otherwise.
Yeah, we'll see. So far, you know, makes for interesting reading.
So your partner, Tara Brantley, mm-hmm. she's awesome, apparently.
She's quite awesome. She's very awesome. I mean, so where do you want to start? Locally, she's in the History Center right now with a big display there that they, wow. I think, have running through May. Mm-hmm. That's interesting to see her progression and just, you know, because she spent most of her career mm-hmm. at Wayne 15, and then just within the last couple weeks was announced that she's being inducted into the Associated Press Hall of Fame.
Wow.
Which is just an incredible honor uh-huh. and is incredibly calming and relaxing for me mm-hmm. when things go wrong and I just look over and I'm like...
She's the Hall of Fame.
It's like pass the ball to Michael Jordan. Here, you take this.
You do it.
You know, yeah. So it's great. Uh-huh. I mean, and it's well-deserved too mm-hmm. because, I mean, she tells stories so well, and I think for the first 6 months I sat along next to her reading the news, I don't think she messed up one time.
Really?
Like, I honestly Ooh. Thought this is not human.
This
you know,
is not real.
It just was just everything, no matter what they threw at her, just flawless.
So you would say she doesn't have a blooper reel?
Does she hide it? She might be on it, but it's not her fault usually.
Uh-huh.
I mean, there's been a couple, you know, where I've heard some things that are like, oh, that's in the blooper reel.
Mm-hmm.
But
good luck finding it. She probably hides it somewhere.
Yeah.
I mean,
I mean, the thing is, live television, everybody's going to have a blooper reel.
Sure.
Just because every now and then they punch up the wrong camera and mm-hmm. all of a sudden you're like, oh, I'm on. I have nothing to say, but
put your makeup down.
Yeah, right. Exactly. Oh, yeah. So,
yeah. But you were in radio too.
That's the fun part for me.
So, how was the transition from radio to TV? How was that?
Radio has one microphone. I know what microphone I'm going to talk into. Uh-huh. Halfway through the sentence, I don't have to switch to this microphone. Uh-huh. It's the same microphone the whole day.
Uh-huh.
And then you know, TV, it's like. Pick a camera. What uh-huh. camera are we talking to?
Oh,
that
camera. Yeah.
Next to this.
The red light.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
Usually tells you. Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
So that was the biggest adjustment. You know, my wife would say, no, the biggest adjustment was you had to go buy suits and ties.
Ah. Yeah, because in radio, you can wear a chicken suit or whatever you want.
Yeah, right. No, I think chicken suit's preferred.
So, hey.
But yeah, so just, yeah. That was, it was an adjustment.
So you were like all time frames. I mean, overnights, morning drives.
Yeah,
all that?
I mean, for the most part, in 30 years of radio, most of it was the morning. Uh-huh. So I was used to getting up at, you know, 4 in the morning and being at work at 4:30. And now I get up at whenever and uh-huh. don't have to get in the shower till 1:30 in the afternoon.
Nice.
You know, I was
we're
back
in the wrong
in
profession,
bed.
Tony.
Yeah, so. But your night schedule's probably kind of whacked, isn't it, because of the...
No, it's funny. I come home after the 11 o'clock news. I get home by about midnight, and I go to bed by 12:30.
Wow. Oh, well, that's not
that
bad.
That would fit your schedule, Tony.
Yeah.
So I heard that you did something strange. You left your wife alone with Bill Cosby? What's this about?
Well, okay. That's one way to put it. But yes, that's technically true. Many years ago, before cell phones, he was at the Embassy Theater, and mm-hmm. I was asked, "Hey, do you want to go introduce Bill Cosby?" And I'm
"Wow,
like,
that's cool."
Well, yeah, of course. Who wouldn't?
Yeah, right.
Back then, who wouldn't say yes to that?
So my wife
and
I
went, and we were told, "You know, you're not going to meet him, mm-hmm. so don't bring anything to sign, mm-hmm. and you're not going to, you know, don't bring cameras and none of that." And so we go downstairs, or we get to the Embassy, and we find the stage person or whatever, and they're like, "Well, it's early enough. Do you want to meet him?"
Wow.
And we're like, yeah, of course we want to meet Bill Cosby.
Uh-huh.
So we go downstairs, and he had ordered a pizza from the Hilton across the street, mm-hmm. and he's just eating a pizza, talking on the phone. We talked about everything under the sun, uh-huh. you know, forever. And then he's like, well, I guess, you know, it's time for the show. My wife was going to leave.
Mm-hmm.
He said, so I go out to introduce him. But he told my wife, he's like, no, you stay here. I'm going to walk you out. He's like, I'm going to bring you on stage.
Okay.
So there was a moment where I, you know, like, ladies and gentlemen, Bill Cosby. And then he walks out like he's walking her down the aisle, puts her on my hand, and he's like, you married way over your head.
Yeah.
But for a brief moment,
yes,
backstage at the Embassy, my wife was alone with Bill Cosby.
Fascinating.
Wow. And that was how long ago?
Well, it was before cell phones, so what would that be? 2003, four, somewhere in that neighborhood?
It was the car phone era. But
right, yeah. You didn't have a camera in your phone.
No,
so, yeah,
right.
A flip phone maybe or whatever.
Wow.
Yeah, bag phone, something like that.
So I'm glad that that worked out.
Yeah,
okay.
Right. I mean, now looking back,
yeah.
What was I thinking?
Yeah. Lee has a question.
I do.
Okay.
So
I do this too.
He does this all the time to me. Okay, so before radio,
yeah,
and before your paper run,
Paper route, paper,
paper
route.
Route.
Paper
yeah.
route.
Yeah.
So
paper
you're
route, yeah.
you're a local boy, correct?
Well,
for the most. For
yes, I mean, I grew up in Grand County, so an hour south. But
sure, close.
Yeah, we got Fort Wayne TV, and we came to Fort Wayne all the time.
Yeah, so what, big city.
What
big
part
city.
Of oh, yeah. what part of going to Northside? We heard that you went to Northside.
No.
No.
Father-in-law.
Your father-in-law
taught at Northside
for
about 40 some years.
Wow.
So he probably would have taught our wives. My wife.
Your wife.
Maybe.
Your wife.
Yeah, I mean, that is the number one question I get asked when people go out, because we ran that commercial on Wayne 15 where I talked about, you know, I'm married to Snyder grad,
right.
and my wife, or my kids went to Carroll, and my father-in-law taught at Northside for 40 plus years, but we don't say who it is.
Oh, no,
so
no.
everybody's like, no. well, who is it?
No.
And it's Coach Don Hunter. Mm-hmm. He's still there, hanging out around.
Really?
He volunteers still for athletic events.
Uh-huh.
And he, you know, he's in the State Hall of Fame for wrestling because he was the head wrestling coach. He was assistant football coach and got to coach in the All-Star game.
Mm-hmm.
Was there, you know, helping athletics, and then you know apparently taught math too.
Ah, whatever.
Right, whatever. Yeah. but yeah, was there for 40 years.
So mustache music.
Fort Wayne. What's the one thing that bugs you about Fort Wayne? I mean, everything's great.
Yeah, right.
It's a great place to raise. I mean, I got four kids. We raise the kids here.
I have said since I moved here that this town, whoever named the streets was drunk.
Oh.
I mean, it's just. And now that I'm working in, you know, in trying to get things right on TV,
yeah.
it has become more apparent.
Yeah.
Like just in the last few months, I didn't realize there's two second streets in Fort Wayne. There's one down by the airport besides like around Wells, you know.
Yeah,
that
yeah
whole,
sure.
Nope, there's more down, you know, Coliseum, I've always said, it makes me laugh. Coliseum north, south, east, west,
uh-huh.
It's not a circle.
No.
It should, you know,
but yeah, it's got all those names.
It's got all those names.
You got Ardmore turns into Hillegas turns into Huguenard.
Yeah, right.
One
yeah,
road,
exactly.
three
One
names.
Road, you never turn, but you're on three different
yeah.
streets. This is the one I just learned that 327, so you take Coldwater north, you're uh-huh. going up towards Garrett.
Yeah.
327, depending on where you are, apparently can either be County Road 327 or
oh.
State Road 327.
Oh. Wow.
Right?
Yeah, how confusing is that?
Right?
Sure.
Yeah. So again, it makes no
so
sense.
So there should be a law.
Have you driven in the country around here? Like north of, we have like 900 east turns
right.
into 200 south.
See, I grew up on that though. That kind of makes sense.
Yeah, that
confuses
us. That's a measurement thing.
But I think you get the rivers going and you cross the river and all of a sudden, you know, 27 becomes Lima, becomes
Clinton, Spy Run, all that
right,
stuff.
Right, depending on if you're going north or south, Lafayette,
yeah.
27, and it's like,
it
wait,
is a mess.
I didn't turn.
Yeah. I'm lost.
So I would prefer that they just pave the roads with certain colors.
Uh-huh. Oh, yeah, okay, there you go.
Whatever, nobody has to read the street sign. Just stay on the blue road
uh-huh.
until you get to Science Central.
Yeah.
There you go.
You know.
But then you got burnt sienna, you've got...
Well, yeah,
you
but
really
you can do patterns,
colors.
You can do checks and polka dots and uh-huh. things like that.
Are you up for a challenge?
Oh.
What happens if I say no?
We'll edit one in.
Of course I am.
Why not?
Of
okay.
course I am.
Because you know I'm Master Station. He's wearing a tie. I'm wearing my tie. We are going to have a little challenge, and Lee is going to talk about, because I don't, I usually cheat.
Duh.
But I can't cheat if I don't know what's going on. So,
the challenge is going to be because we have two news. Worthy individual, well, one
no
newsworthy individual in you is I'm going to give you a topic. You'll have 10 seconds to prepare your thoughts, and then it'll be a breaking news topic. You'll have 1 minute to let us have it. The other person has to plug their ears.
Oh, honor system.
Can't hear. Then the same topic we give to the other person, and then our studio audience, by clap-o-meters that you have underneath your chairs, will decide who won that challenge. And if we have time, we have two possible topics.
Yes.
But one for sure.
Since our time is up, we have one.
All right, we'll do one.
Now, do I hear the topic?
No.
I don't hear the topic
and
what he says, or
no,
just the topic?
No, you don't hear anything.
Okay. So who's first? You choose who's first.
I'll let you go first, because we'll all laugh.
Shrink it. Yes! Okay.
So I'm plugging my ears.
Yes, plug your ears.
Just act like you're.
Okay.
All right.
Okay, Tony, your topic?
Okay.
Polar bear sighting in Columbia City.
Okay, polar bear sighting in Columbia City. Okay.
And
you ready? All right.
Roll.
Good evening. There has been a polar bear sighted in Columbia City. Three men are missing, and on the downtown street, they will find those three men in different large segments. Back to you.
That was weak.
That was really bad.
What do you think? All right, you
that
can take
it. Okay.
So by studio audience, clap-o-meter, you're about a
four. Out of zero.
4 out of 10.
Okay.
That was not so good. Okay. Well, you have to plug your ears.
I just did it.
Okay, fine. But you can't comment then.
I will say anything.
All right. So your topic, polar bear sighting in Columbia City. Take 10 seconds to formulate.
That was my problem. I didn't take 10 seconds.
Big mistake.
Yeah. Okay.
And when you're ready,
ready?
Action.
This is just in. We have breaking news. We have reports of a polar bear sighting out of Columbia City. Authorities are trying to figure out where the polar bear came from and how it was released into the streets of Columbia City. At this point, we have no confirmed reports of injuries, although several people are running for their lives.
All right. That wasn't fair.
And this is where I would say, Tara, back to you.
That's nice.
We have a live reporter on the scene being chased by the polar bear.
I think that the meter just went off the rails there on his, because mine was pretty poor.
Yeah. So. Well, no, yours was terrible. So I think that by the audience clap-o-meter, you got an 8.
That was an awesome, awesome.
Well, it's not really fair because we've actually had that story.
We have.
We have.
We've had a polar what?
Bear. Polar bear.
Oh. Was it a Russian plant, perhaps? Well, everybody, welcome, audience. Dirk Rowley for being here. Thank him, and we're going to be right back after this. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
And now it's time for a Mastication Station infiltration selection. Hey!
Whoa! Watch the wind, Tony!
Oh boy!
Okay. Woo! It's
wind. B. C.
Oh my! Whoa, that was better! Okay.
And D.
Oh.
Please comment below with your selection.
Have you ever wondered what it would be like to have your life held in the balance by a 15-year-old driving student? Shh, keep driving. Well, wonder no more. Order your copy of A Blunderful Joyride, Memoirs of a Driving Instructor, on sale now at Amazon.com or in your grocer's freezer. A Blunderful Joyride. Like it on Facebook, love it at Amazon.com, read it wherever you read things.
Can we get a pedal that'll show the teleprompter?
Yeah.
And if I hit this button,
we
get paid.
Whoa!
Whoa. That's like being on a roller coaster.
Hi, everybody.
That's more than we can. We don't have the budget for that.
We're back, and we're looking at our new toy here.
It's our director.
And
it was our director.
Little chop shop here. Little chop shop talk.
Yeah, it's got our new budget.
Yeah,
this with our new budget.
Because mm-hmm. of the previous sponsor, which right. was not the what
not
was it?
Not Jethro Tull's.
No, the
cowbells
one it was like the mulch and mushroom farm or something like that.
The worm farm. Yeah. Worm and mushroom farm.
Yeah. Because of them, we were able to save a couple bucks back.
They were able to dig up some profits for us.
Yeah. And so we got the director who's on stilts now. So that's pretty cool, really.
I'm out of range.
He's out of range. So I guess that's it.
Now
so
we have a total crew of.
You want to direct?
No.
Oh, no,
I don't.
Don't give
I better
that to
not.
Tony. He'll play. He'll lose
I might
it.
Get fries out of
he'll
it.
He'll steal
something.
It.
So that was pretty nifty.
So now we have camera crew. dynamite camera crew. It goes everywhere with us.
Crack crew.
Stay in the van.
Yep.
We now have a director. Mm-hmm. We have Ron, who's a sound expert.
Yeah.
It's called a mobile director.
Yeah,
mobile director.
So we're moving on up.
So
the
we need a bigger van because these guys keep complaining about the van we have now is small.
The van is next. The van's the
we
next
need a new
thing
van
to upgrade. Yeah,
well,
we're gonna
Bob's
get
our cameraman.
Yeah.
And our bus driver.
Yeah. So we have to get out of that Schwinn and move on to an actual vehicle. So
with the banana seat.
Yeah, it was actually a horse's.
It's just fun to watch three of those in the banana seats in the back.
Yeah. Well, hey, that was a fun show. I don't remember what happened, but...
We had that Dirk guy.
Yeah, that was like well past the last commercial, so I don't really know.
He is so professional.
Professional guy. So
now we know the standard we need to work towards.
I know now what it's like to talk to somebody who has personality, so... where
I hope none of our previous guests watch this show.
Where are we going to be at next?
I think, actually, you know, we've been talking about going to Europe.
Yeah.
I think we're going to go... Across the pond.
We've been threatening it for a long time.
Across the pond to England.
Yeah. Yeah. Is there a...
Castles.
A little borough or something that we can go to?
Well, there's Edinburgh, but that's more Scotland.
That's true.
That's north of London. I think we're going to shoot for London.
Yeah.
And we'll do the Big Ben tour with those red buses where we sit on top and the bottom.
Yeah.
And put you on top with a low bridge. And then
that?
Our cameraman just passed out. Hey, you're supposed to be taking our pictures, not taking your own pictures, big boy. Can we cut his pay?
I was actually pretty pleased about the 15 here. I mean, that was the last time I did a cardboard thing like that. Remember when we had the
portable audience?
Yeah.
The audience left and you had your portable audience.
Portable audience. That was pretty...
You know, everyone's going to think this is like 15-yard line.
Yeah. I think the grease stains are actually a good touch,
Channel 15.
So. Yeah. So,
yeah.
Good pizza, good time, good 15's a good fun. So.
And the Oddfellow crew, Oddfellow audience.
Fantastic
audience. Yeah. One of our best audiences.
Of all time, at least here.
At least in the last 24 hours is the best audience we've had.
Yeah, so, and then we didn't have to have the hotel because we're in town. Change
that's
the
nice.
Sheets in our bed and all that stuff,
Maybe
so that was
about
good.
Time.
Well, when they walk on their own,
next
I
time
guess
you stay at my house, you're on the couch. I don't care.
Leather when you
slide
squeak.
Off.
Yeah.
You notice my couch is at a 2-degree angle.
Yeah.
So by midnight, you're off. You slide right off.
There's a reason for that.
They don't want guests to stay light. Yeah.
Stay lit?
Lit and
light.
Light them right up.
If you would like to email us, fax us. They keep changing the cameras, my goodness.
I'm getting a headache just watching.
If you want to email us and fax us, phone us.
Quips.
Vignettes. Humorous vignettes.
Vignettes.
He knows the
vinaigrettes.
Routine. You can email us. Oh, the 15's upside down.
Now it's 50 when it's 21.
How'd that happen?
They just put it upside down.
Well, that is weird. How did you do that?
I think our director's messing with us.
He's trying to get me.
Mastication
Station. They're wearing size
like
15s
now. We have a ghost in the studio.
It's right up there. See it? Mastication Station at yahoo.com. Mastication Station at yahoo.com if you want to give us any money. So
we
obviously need it. We have all this new equipment. We've got to
get
do
rid
it.
Of all these plants that are probably going to kill us.
We got out of the
people.
JCPenney catalog. And
I thought it was a Sears and Roebuck.
It's
catalog.
Well, one of those. So
one of the old 60s.
Next time we're going to be where in Europe?
In
you
London.
Say?
We're going to be in London.
London. We're going to be in London. And we're going to have some British guests.
Mm-hmm.
And we have
some
portable teeth.
And tea. A lot of tea.
A
lot of tea over there.
We'll be back then. Have a good night. Have a good weekend. Have a good summer. Have a good fall.
Have a good
spring,
April.
And a good April.
Good April.
We'll see you then. Bye.
not touching me!